Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, Makeup Couture by Jetty. Today I create this frame time look. If you want to recreate this look, please stay tuned. I used MAC NC42 to create a highlight up under my brow bone. And don't forget to blend out your highlight to create a more natural and flawless look. So as you can see, I'm blending down. Now I'm using the NARS eye primer. I'm applying that to my entire lid. I love this primer. It ensures that it does not crease and your eyeshadow stays on all day. A little bit of this eye primer goes a long way. Now I'm using MAC Saddle as my transition color. And I'm using my MAC 224 fluffy brush to blend this out. Blending is key when it comes to applying your eyeshadow. This creates a more natural and flawless look, so you won't have any harsh lines as you're applying your eyeshadow. Next, I'm going to apply, I believe this is brown script. That into my crease to create a little bit of definition. Now you may be wondering why I have tape on the side of my eyes. Well, I have hooded eyes, so if I apply tape, it creates an illusion that my eyes are going up instead of going down. And it also creates a nice clean look. Taking a little bit of Embark and I'm mixing that with a little bit of Saddle to create a little bit of depth in my crease, just a slight definition into my crease. I'm taking my MAC 217 with nothing on it and just making sure that I'm blending everything in, so therefore there will not be any hard lines. This is a more tapered black brush, so it allowed me to get more into my crease versus the 224 brush. Now I'm taking my favorite pigment for highlight, which is MAC Naked, and I'm applying that up under my brow bone. I'm not using my Naked pigment, I am using MAC Arena as my highlight. Now I'm taking my Makeup Forever Flash Palette in Coral. This will be the base for my lid. And then I'm going to apply Urban Decay Peaches on my lid on top of that base. And don't forget, once you're done applying your eye color to your lid, take your brush, go back in and blend. You want to make sure that everything is blended. Now I'm taking MAC Black Track Eyeliner.
Now, this is one of my favorite eyeliners. If not, then I'm using Wet n Wild in Black Dress. I believe that's the color. I always keep that in my makeup kit for my clients. Now I'm taking my Becca Matte Pore Finish Primer. I'm applying that to my forehead and also to my nose and my cheeks and my chin. I have combination skin, so I'm really oily in my T-zone area. I'm kind of dry in my forehead. But I'm making sure that this primer is all over my face, especially my chin. Now I'm taking my MAC corrector in Burnt Coral, and usually I will correct under my eyes for dark circles and my nose because I have a little bit of red spots and my acne scars as well. And of course, I'm going to blend that out. I'm just taking a sponge and just blending. Now I'm using my Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation, and I believe that is a nutmeg if I'm not mistaken. If not, I will link that in the description box. But I'm using my Real Techniques buffing brush to blend out my foundation. Yes, so you won't have any lines. Now I am getting ready to highlight and contour. I'm using my MAC concealer and NC42 to highlight up under my eyes, my forehead, my chin, the bridge of my nose, and sometimes I will highlight my Cupid's bow. Thank you. I would use a sponge that I get from Walmart. One of the disposal sponges for me to blend out my highlight up under my eye. Get ready to blend. I'm so silly. Now I'm getting ready to blend everything out up under my eyes with a small foundation brush. I believe this is from Sigma. And there go my little trusty stick, my little blend.